you. It is Tuesday, it is cloudy, and we are fresh from spring break.
Yes.
My name's Marcia.
I'm Mackenzie Davis.
And so how have you been coping after spring break?
I haven't. I'm so exhausted. I don't believe in spring break. I don't think it's a real thing. Like, it's a break where you don't actually like have to go to class, but you still have homework and schoolwork to do. So that's what my spring break consisted of, just doing homework while volunteering too. So I was doing two things at once.
So you're productive, that's good.
Yeah.
I spent most of my spring break working. I tried getting like 50 hours at both of my jobs. So it was trying times, but I think my paycheck is gonna look pretty pretty good after that.
And where was it? Men's Warehouse, and what was the second job?
I work human resources at the union. So
okay.
If you need a job over there, then hit your girl up.
Well, I'd need a job. Well, thanks. Nice. Well, I wish spring break was a little bit longer than a week. I feel like it actually lasts maybe 2 days. Yeah, that's what it feels like.
I feel like at the end of it, it's just, 1 week is not enough time to kind of just decompress and then get ready for another.
Yeah, but luckily we only have 6 weeks left of school. I just held up 10, but I meant to do 6. Yep, we only have 6 weeks left of school. So hopefully that'll go by really quick, as fast as spring break went. But let's check out everybody else's pictures.
Yeah.
We can see what the rest of our crew did. Here's Letty. She was at the Sea Life Aquarium in Kansas City. So
looks like she's having a good time.
Yeah. And then we have Keely. She has two pictures. She was actually in Fort Myers Beach in Florida for the week. So look at that. That's a great picture.
She's having a great time.
Yeah.
Super tan.
And then this is actually my picture. I'm not in it, but as you can see, our co-host here, Marcia, is in it. So when I was at the gym, this showed up, and I just had to take a picture of it. So, yep, I was at the gym and volunteering mostly for the spring break.
So. I'm glad I could spend spring break with you.
Yeah.
We had Boone. He was spending time with his nephew, Oliver, who's super adorable, rocking that grow outfit.
Yep. And then we have Ian here at the Cryo Salon. I don't even know what that is. That looks like very cold. If that's the machine where they freeze you, then I got to get in there. Then we have our producer, Martin, here. He was in Chicago. Looks nice. I've never actually been to Chicago.
I haven't either.
Yep. Then we have our host. I'm sorry, not our host. Our co-worker, I guess you can call her, Katie. She's at Key West, Florida. I'm just distracted by the picture, so excuse me. But that's a really good picture.
Good angle there.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just jealous. Yep. And then Malik, he was at home, which we can all relate. I was at home too.
Looks like so, he's watching the game, and he's
yeah.
That must have been in the first half.
Yep. Just the first half. It's very sad, but nice transition for us to talk about a very sad moment.
We had our last game of the season over spring break, which was super disappointing.
Yeah.
I know it was the very first time my dad watched any KU basketball game. I've been going to this school for 3 years, and it's the first time he actually sat down to watch a game, and we lost. So it is Bill Say's fault that we did not make it into the Final Four, I'm convinced.
Yep, now we know who to complain to.
Exactly.
And who to blame.
Send all of your letters to me. I'll forward them on to him.
Yep. Just make them kind, like nice, but not too harsh if you send a letter.
Because if we're being fair, the Oregon Ducks did play a pretty good game.
Yep.
And Frank Mason went out fighting, that's for sure.
That's good. That's good.
Well, we have a few things to look forward to.
Yeah, and you're part of SUA, so I'm pretty sure you have a lot of events to tell us about.
Oh my goodness, we have so many events. Starting with tomorrow, we have Tunes at Night featuring Dream Girl. That's over at the Lead Center. They're a super fun band. I haven't really gotten a lot of chances to listen to them, but I know they're pretty popular in Lawrence, so I'm really excited for that. And we always have some free food there, like some goat cheese and stuff. It's always really good. And then we have Farmers Ball coming up, which is kind of like an annual thing that we do with KJHK, the radio station. Semifinals are April 8th, and the finals are April 15th. You get to go and vote on your favorite band. I think Farmers Ball makes it sound a little bit.
Yeah, I was going to say, I've never heard of that before, so that's fun.
It's just a battle of the bands. It sounds like it would be country. It's not.
Yeah.
Country music.
Yeah, I think it's the Farmers. Yep.
Yeah, it's coming up. And then this Friday, we actually have KU's Got Talent, and I got to sit on the auditions for that. And we have some pretty interesting people that are going to be up there. Lots of singing. But I know we have like a yo-yo guy, so That's pretty cool.
I don't know how to yo-yo, so.
I could never. It's I watched him do it, and I was just so perplexed the entire time.
Yeah, I was one of those kids that just threw it around, like, all the time. They're like, no, you're supposed to bounce it up and down. I'm like, nope, I'm going to bounce it at your head, if anything.
I broke all of my.
That was the kid I was.
I begged my mom. I was like, get me a new yo-yo. And she'd go, no, Marcy, you're going to break it. And then I did, and then I would cry, and then ask for another one, and she just, it was a mess, so.
We're a mess today. Well, welcome back, students. It's been pretty rough, but we will get through it. We will get through these last 6 weeks. But stay tuned. We will have our interview with our host, Katie Trigg.
Where you go to college makes a statement about you. This place will become a part of you, your identity for life. The University of Kansas, a great place to be you.
Hi, welcome back to Good Morning KU. I'm Julia Peterson and I'm here with Katie. So we both had some pretty crazy and fun spring breaks. So where'd you go for spring break?
Well, my break was kind of like an interesting story. It was fun for the most part, but we had a little weird experience. So my family, we were gonna go on a cruise that was gonna dock in Key West and Cozumel, Mexico. And so we were able to dock in Key West and that was really fun. And so we got back on the ship and we were gonna go all night and wake up in the morning and be in Cozumel. Mm-hmm. But when we were sleeping, the captain, he woke us up with like an emergency. I'm like, oh my gosh, like I'm in the Titanic. Like what is going on? This is not okay. But after that, he said there was a man overboard and I was kind of like sleeping, so I was kind of out of it, I guess. But my mom, she like went up to the top deck and she got some pretty like eerie video because it was like 3 a.m. in the morning and
That's
it was
crazy.
Like pitch black. You could not see anything. And so turns out the Coast Guard showed up and they had us sitting there for a while. I think it was about 16 hours they had us sitting. And
wow.
Basically they found out that the man was probably partying and fell off his balcony on the eighth deck. And it was very sad because
That's
we
really
were never
sad.
Able to find him and we never made it to Mexico, but
That's disappointing.
Very sad. I just have to say though, everyone was really respectful on the ship though, and it was really nice because really there's nothing you can do with a situation like that.
Mm-hmm.
But we all made the most of it. So it wasn't like a crazy awesome spring break, but it is what it is, I guess.
That sounds insane. That's like my biggest fear, just like
yeah.
being on a ship and an emergency thing.
Oh yeah,
on.
That was my first cruise ship. So it was
what like goes through your mind when that happens?
I don't know. I guess the first thing I thought it was like the Titanic, literally, because he was just like emergency, and we were like down on a low deck, so sleeping, I could just kind of feel myself rocking anyway. So I mean, it was kind of cool, but being on your first cruise ship with something like that happens, it was like, mm-hmm. oh my gosh. But you could not see anything. We were probably like 30 miles from Cuba. You couldn't see lighthouses. Like the moon was covered by clouds. Like it was
That's terrible.
So dark.
So how long were you on your trip?
It was only a 4-day cruise. So I know it was really sad that we couldn't do Mexico.
How long were you supposed to be in Mexico?
It was gonna be a full day.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
And we had like a snorkeling trip scheduled and I was really sad because I just got a GoPro. I wanted to use it
yeah.
with all the fish and everything, but like I said, it is what it is.
That's Did you do any other fun activities in other places, though?
Yeah, so we did Key West. That was fun. That was like our first stop. And that's cool because it's the most southern point in the United States. So there's like a big line of people to take a picture like on the most southern like land point. Yeah, so it was pretty cool. But yeah.
All right. Well, anything else you want to add?
Not really. I guess just kind of everyone.
Glad everyone's
like,
safe.
Send your hearts out to that man's family. He's 23. His name was
That's
Paul.
So
but yeah,
Aww.
I know.
Well, stay tuned when we come back. We're going to have the news update. Thank you.
Have a nice day.
You too.
Ha ha ha!
Welcome back. I'm Keely McCormick.
And I'm Melanie Shaner, and this is your news update for March 28, 2017. Former Vice President Joe Biden thinks that he could have won both the 2016 Democratic primary and the presidential election. During a lecture series at Colgate University in New York, Biden admitted on Friday that he had planned on running, but that decision came during a difficult time for him when his son, Beau, died of brain cancer in May of 2015. 5 months later, he announced that he wouldn't join the presidential race. Later on, he admitted that he doesn't regret not running, but he does regret not being president.
The cruise ship company Cunard is planning another epic around-the-world cruise that will include stops at more than 30 ports on six continents. The 107-night voyage on the Queen Victoria will kick off on January 10, 2019 in Southampton, England, and end in the same port on April 27, 2019. Cunard pioneered the concept of around-the-world voyages nearly a century ago and has offered dozens of the trips over the years.
Two people have died following a house fire in Kansas City, Missouri. The incident happened on Monday afternoon in the 400 block of Colorado Avenue near Smart Avenue. Fire crews arrived on the scene to find flames shooting from the home and found two bodies inside. Police said that the property was vacant and boarded up at the time of the fire. The victims have only been identified as a man and a woman, and the incident is under investigation.
And that's all we have for you for news. Stay tuned. Rune will be back with sports after the break.
Where you go to college makes a statement about you. This place will become a part of you, your identity for life. The University of Kansas, a great place to be you.
Hi there, I'm Rune Jones. I'm here with your sports update. The men's basketball team ended their season in the NCAA tournament on March 25th against Oregon. The team will be losing their beloved seniors, Frank Mason, Landon Lucas, and Tyler Self. Frank Mason was named one of the five finalists for the 2017 John R. Wooden Award, as well as Josh Jackson on the Wooden Award All-American team. The men's baseball team will play today and tomorrow against Minnesota at Hulig to continue their 9-game homestead streak. The Jayhawks took two hard falls the last time they played the Golden Gophers towards the end of the season in May. The Jayhawks are coming off the two losses and one win against Stanford. Senior closer Stefan Villens was named one of the 30 candidates to be considered for the 2017 Senior Class Award in Collegiate Baseball. The women's softball team fell to Baylor 5-1 on Sunday in the pitcher's duel between Kansas pitcher Alexis Reed and Baylor's Kelsey Selman. The Jayhawks will take on the Oklahoma State Cowboys for a 3-game series starting on Friday at 6 p.m. in Oklahoma. And to stay tuned with Andrew for weather coming up.
Welcome back. My name's Andrew, and we have Ian outside of Anschutz right now. Ian, can you tell us what it feels like outside right now? Ian, can you hear me?
Sort of like overcast, coldish, but like it's a little, I guess, prickly.
Yeah. Yeah. Do you see any students walking around? Are they in short sleeves and shorts, or are they like bundled up in light jackets and whatnot?
Most people are bundled up. Everyone has a jacket as plus. There's a few brave souls that kind of either didn't look at the phone this morning or just want to stay through it and, like, decide to, like, go out short.
Yeah. Yeah, understandable. And right now, do you wish that you were somewhere else where it's sunny and 75 outside, or are you happy with the overcast weather we have today?
I mean, I don't want spring break to be over, especially since, like, school, but, like, yeah, I would totally, like, go anywhere that's, like, nice and sunny, lay out on the beach and tan a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah, I feel you too. I wish I was back in Florida with the sunny 75 weather, but that's good. Well, thank you for going outside today. And as we're moving on to today's weather, we can see that we're going to have a high of 57 degrees with an overcast and those winds out of the east today. And then breaking down your day for you, we can see that at 11 a.m., it's going to be around 52 degrees. So moving into the 3 p.m. hour, our temperature is going to be around 56 degrees. And into the 5 p.m. hour, we'll have this that high temperature for the day around 57, and as the sun is beginning to set, our temperature will slowly start to decrease, but not decrease too much until we're into the overnight hours tonight with a temperature of 49 degrees. And the rain chance is moving, and that rain isn't going to happen anytime today, but tomorrow at 1, or be in our area around 1 a.m. for your Wednesday, with those winds picking up as that storm's moving in. And then looking at tomorrow, our high temperature will be 58 degrees, with that being rainy all day. And then the winds out of the south at 5 to 10 miles per hour, which is where our storm system's coming from. That rain will be with us most of the day, so it's going to be on during the early morning when you're still sleeping before your classes come up. And then it's going to slow down a little during the middle of the day and then pick back up into the evening for your evening activities. And then we do have that severe chance tomorrow evening. And then looking at this graphic that the National Weather Service out of Topeka put out, we can see that most of the state of Kansas is going to expect rain of about 2 inches, a little less for some areas. Lawrence is expected to have rain about 1.86, and then Kansas City just to our east, they are going to expect a little more, around 2 inches and whatnot. But as you can see, this is going to be widespread throughout most of our Wednesday and into our Thursday. So it's just going to be very, like, grimy for you to walk out, and something you just have to deal with in a sense. And so it's going to be localized heavy rain for our early morning tomorrow. So that means flooding is possible in low-lying areas because it's going to be heavy downpours at times. Other than that, we do have that severe risk tomorrow, with the main threats being the lightning and hail. But tornado risk at the moment isn't zero, but it's very low. So that's going to be mainly towards our south, towards the southern portion of Kansas and into Oklahoma and Texas. And then looking at the 5-day forecast for the rest of your week, we can see that it's going to be a high of 56 on Thursday with a 50% chance of rain. That's going to be just rain. There's no severe weather in with that, so no lightning or thunder, just that rain chance there. And then Friday, we are going to have partly sunny skies, so that's going to be a great day to go out and enjoy this nice weather that we are going to have for the end of our week, starting our weekend. And then on to the weekend, our temperature will be 62 degrees, so it's going to be a nice and warm up a little bit, but it's going to be the little grimy and have 30% chance of rain, so that chance can increase. It's still a little too far out to see, but just to be aware of that. And then before we close off today, just be sure that you have that rain jacket and umbrella with you tomorrow, as that rain chance will be with us all day tomorrow at that 90% chance. Other than that, enjoy this weekend and enjoy the nice rain weather that we're having that will hopefully bring some nice April flowers into our area. Other than that, that's all we have for Good Morning KU today. Thank you for joining, and we hope to see you right back here next Tuesday at 10 a.m.